In the heart of North Carolina, just outside Raleigh, the Carolina Hurricanes on home ice, ready for another NHL matchup. Greetings, everyone, with Eddie Olczyk. Ray Ferraro will be seen and heard in just a moment. And right now, I'm Mike Emmerich, about to pose the question. You were on good teams. You were on not-so-good teams. Tonight, we get to see one of the not-so-good teams. What's it like?
It's tough. I mean, it really tests your love of the game. It tests your passion for the game. But for me, you look at the standings, you know there are a lot of teams above you, Doc, but I always thought about let's try to go out there, not necessarily win the game. You want that, but let's win the first period. Let's see what happens after the first 20 minutes of the game and then go from there. So I think small steps is such an important approach when you're a struggling team.
Carolina's got the right game plan. They might not have the best talent. They might not have the top goaltenders, but they certainly are trying to play the right way, and eventually they will work themselves out from the bottom of the standings.
Let's look at the starting netminders. Ward's the man with the heaviest equipment and responsibility tonight for the Hurricanes. His record shows so-so, winning percentage average. Some of the fans are saying he's not getting any help from his teammates. Murray's the other union rep among the goaltenders trade for the Penguins. The save percentage glares back at you, doesn't it? Well, tonight, perhaps it will be headed up.
Pittsburgh's offensive output over the last 10 games has carried them through this great stretch. They want to continue to turn the heat up on an opponent that has really, really had a tough time.
Pass cut, strong play. Comes on back for reinforcement. Into the end of attack. Gathered in by Crosby. Good defensive play, hand to eye and center ice. Puck corralled by Fall. Carolina shifting gears as they travel through center ice. Not a free puck now. The Penguins move to center ice. Shoots. Oh, what a break. That shot hit somebody. Big drive. They score. And one goes up on the board for the visitors.
Necessarily how hard you shoot it, but where you shoot it, and that was perfectly placed.
Ward's only able to move so quickly. What a shot.
Pittsburgh's ahead by one goal here in the first period. A lot of time still left to play, but getting one and breaking the tie was huge. Nice steal there by Stepniak. He gains the zone. Shoots it on. They score! And they've tied the game up.
The goal scorer put that puck in a shooting position, let it go, and beat the goaltender clean.
Murray's got an excellent glove hand, but his desperation attempt here is not enough. Up over the glove and in.
The Hurricanes with a win at center. Into the attacking end. Turned away. Pitching it to Hornquist. Has it in his own end. What a hit!
You don't see those type of collisions very often.
Hainsey's down after that hit, Doc.
He scores! Might not have been his target for the year, but it's a good one to arrive at. 30 goals.
He had that wrist shot ready to go in a perfect scoring area.
And so sometimes your best isn't enough. That is a perfect shot up over the glove hand. The goaltender just was not able to get to it.
Pittsburgh's ahead by one goal here in the first period. A lot of time still left to play, but getting one and breaking the tie was huge. Carolina's got another faceoff win. Gathered in by Rask. Teravainen's hooked on the play. There will be a penalty.
Final of the goal, 6 minutes, 14 seconds.
One team is going to be short from this. Let's see what the call is. Pittsburgh's two-minute penalty is a minor, and the call is hooking.
This was okay about 10 years ago. Not anymore. That's a hooking call.
The Hurricanes go on the power play for the first time.
Pittsburgh penalty to number 51.
A good tie-up on the faceoff. That led to his team getting the puck. No!
How did he shoot the puck that quick?
That one comes out of the air and is nice down to the ice. With a blast! Hung right over him and couldn't get it past.
The goalie makes himself look big.
Collected in the corner. No room for a pass. Can't get a shot on. Tries to clear, and that one cleared by the penalty killers. Puck gathered in by Falk. Passing one off now to Hennepin. Now it's directed to Skinner. And he's hammered. The Penguins shoot it back out. Got some time to check the clock and prepare to defend again. Huge hit. Possession's gone. Pitching this one to Fair. The Penguins have killed it off. The Hurricanes with possession in center ice. Moving it to Hornquist. Propelled to Fair. That hit somebody. Pass attempt to Teravainen. One into another.
I saw that one coming from a mile away.
Snapping a pass to Malkin. Gets in and he'll look over his options. Good use of the stick. Broke that pass up. Puck is thrown to Lindholm. Laid on to Hornquist. Shoots one. That one blocked. Puck covered, whistle blown.
Crosby's offensive production stems from the fact that he's able to get away from the guy checking him for just a second to release the puck. That is a skill that people don't talk about. Some have it, some don't.
The Hurricanes with a clean win on the draw. The Hurricanes wheel one ahead up the wing. Good stick down on the ice, so nothing good happening there. Trying to go to Hagelin. Good grab again. Perfect tip by the stick. Terrific open ice hit. The defense can rest. Dogged determination there, but that shot came from right in front.
You don't get many better opportunities than that. Great save.
Gets in. What'll he do? Shoots one. No! Gotta get it on net.
Having a heavy shot like that is great, but you gotta hit the net.
Slid to Nordstrom. Walking a thin line near the border there. Let's it go, and he missed it. Wanting to generate something up the wing. With a shot, they score! Sidney Crosby!
Well, what a quick release on that snapper.
That would have been save of the year candidate right there. He tried to make an unbelievable glove stop. Just doesn't get there.
And here's Ray.
Word from the home team's locker room is they're going to be short a player for the rest of the night. The injury occurred a while ago. He will not return.
Fires! Oh, tremendous stop by Ward.
Ward's athleticism allowed him to make that outstanding save.
Directing that one to Nestrashil. Looking to DiGiuseppe. Oh, and the pass wouldn't go. That play is offside, and so back to center ice for the face.
Never satisfied. Never take your foot off the gas pedal. He's got two goals now. He better be thinking about getting number three.
The Hurricanes control from the neutral zone. First period has come to a close. We'll get a rest. So will the teams. The Penguins own a two-goal lead. Let's check out the shots on goal in that opening period. 6 for Carolina, 5 for Pittsburgh. The Penguins end the period with a 2-goal advantage. We focus on this one, the one that made it 2 goals, and we'll have more in just a moment. Minutes in the books, 20 minutes ahead. And so what did you think of the first?
Carolina's lucky to still be in this game after the first period. They had turnover after turnover. I'm sure the coaches addressed that problem in the intermission.
First face-off of period 2. Oh, here's a wrister. Got that in the trapper.
That was all positioning, right into his glove.
The Penguins' center of offense is this player. He has among the highest total points in the league. He has such creativity if it's not him scoring the goal. He's so good to play with as his wingers just have to get open.
Good job tying the man up on the faceoff. Teammate comes in, pitching it to Falk. Moved along and in. Passing one off now to Crosby. Up to the point. Wonderful stop.
A quick developing play right in front. Almost looks like he's too close to the goaltender.
Mata's contributions often come without the puck. He has among the highest hit totals in the league. A punishing player to play against.
Good faceoff win. Puck covered, whistle blown.
Pretty routine stop. You can see why everybody learns the butterfly when they're a young kid. Takes away the bottom of the net.
Tie up and help from the winger. Carolina's lugging it up the wing. Gathered up again by Hornquist. Chip to Jordan Staal. Lofted back in and the forwards get to the bench. Brought ahead towards center. Pittsburgh setting things up in center. Outstanding play. Muscled long to Daly. Guarded the goal again. Nearly grazed the iron on that.
That's going to happen. There's not a lot of room there. He just missed the shot.
On to Teravainen. Propelled to Stempniak. Wonderful save on a terrific scoring chance. Now it's directed to Fair. Didn't get through. Pitching this one to Stempniak. Has it picked up. The Penguins wheel it up the wing. Takes it behind his own cage. Back in the defensive zone towards center ice. Moving it on up the wing. Moving it to McClement. Making attack here. The Penguins with possession in their own end. Gets in. What'll he do? Sauced. Oh, poke check. Saved one there. And drops on back and waits for help. Pass attempt to McClement. Nicely done with the interception. Shot on. Got his pad on that one. Snapping a pass to Fair. Gains the zone. And the loose puck brought in by Phil Kessel. He scores! That's 3 unanswered goals.
That puck looked like it got deflected right in front of the goaltender. I'm sure Ray had a much better look at that.
It did get deflected, Eddie, and when we get a look at it on the replay right here, you're going to see the goalie's in position, but because the puck is deflected the way it was, it gets past him in a way he just can't react to.
A little under 7 minutes to go here in the second. Do you see a pattern developing here? They're up now by 3. Wrist shot. He scores! And that's the hat trick. There won't be many on the ice, if any. But he's got 3 goals.
The goalie was surprised at how quick that snapshot got on him.
Ward's out of position here. He's got to go back against the grain to try and make the glove save. It's just not enough despite his efforts.
The Penguins have added to their overwhelming score, and they continue to have the puck most of the time. Pittsburgh's got it off the draw at center. Laid on to Crosby. The glove like lightning. Gets play stopped.
Crosby's play defensively has grown in leaps and bounds. As a result, he has among the highest plus-minus totals in the league. The Hurricanes talk about their mantra of blocking shots. Well, over the last few games, it's remarkable how many they've got in front of.
Tie up there and a good reach and possession. Missed the net.
You talk to any goaltender, those are tough shots to read when a player shoots it off his backhand.
Got it in his own end. Carolina's accelerating on in neutral ice. It's dumped in. Slid to Kunockel. Right near the line. A shot. Point blank save.
You want to score goals, you have to go to this area.
Puck is thrown to DiGiuseppe. And glides on through center ice. Nicely into the zone. He throws it there. Goes back deep for it. Trying to go to Skinner. Carried toward the neutral zone. Directing that one to Hagelin. He had a great chance, but he has just missed the net. Lindholm's hooked on this play, and the arm of the referee is high. Pittsburgh's roster goes down by one here. At least briefly, a minor penalty for hooking.
The referees are looking for this. Anytime you stop skating and reach with your stick and pull on the opponent, you're going to the penalty box.
Carolina's power play gets another chance to operate. Hasn't been effective yet. Pittsburgh's prevailed on another faceoff. And that's an offside.
You know, these teams are working pretty hard, but again, we notice that there aren't many fans. Do you think the players pay attention to that?
Well, if this team doesn't get their act together, there's going to be no fans at these games.
Tied up, but a good reach and a good step in there for possession. Good poke check by Bonino. The Penguins through the neutral zone accelerate to the line. Brings a shot. Nice poke check by Kunitz. Two periods have been played. They've worked pretty hard at it, and they get a well-deserved rest. Third period coming up shortly. A look at the shots on goal through two. 14 for Pittsburgh and 8 for the Hurricanes. The Hurricanes were counting on a tremendous performance in goal. They counted wrong. More in a moment. Forty minutes have been played. They are getting ready for the third period here. So take us back through the game. What do you think, Eddie?
Pittsburgh's up, Doc, here with a pretty solid lead, but they know that their opponent's going to come after them. So let's see how they play. Will they be defensive first or look to add to the lead that they have?
Carolina's power play gets a chance to work here. Looking to Kunitz. And he steps across the line. Great glove save, but it's loose. Carolina's got it in their own end, hoping for center. Gains the blue line. And angled to Rask. Scorches one. That's what those pads are for. The Penguins are back even. Got in the way of that one, too. Pitching it to Hanifin. Pointed to Skinner. A shot. Oh, what a stop.
Terrific stop from right in front of the net, but you got to find a way to put the puck in the net.
Chooses the corner. Shoots. They can't find the target.
Here's one of those times where you look at the net and there's nothing there. That's where you just got to shoot.
Oh, and he is drilled.
Oh, that nasty hit. Somebody's going to come to the aid of that player.
These two guys don't like one another, and they're proving it now. The scrap is over, and now the penalties for sure, maybe repairs.
There's nobody in here that wasn't entertained by that fight. There's no use risking injury here. I don't know why they take the fight. The game's in their back pocket.
Just a bit over 4 minutes have passed. Pittsburgh's got a decisive lead in this one, 5-1. Solid, clean win. Oh, an error on that pass. Good chance here. Taken on by Skinner. Tripped up on the play, and there will be a penalty. Pittsburgh's got two on this one for tripping.
Well, in desperation mode, all he was trying to do was sweep the puck away, but unfortunately, caught the player's skates. This power play has to find a way to get more people to the net.
You've got it, Eddie. Let's watch to see if you're a prophet here. The Hurricanes win it. And that one goes wide, too.
This team is down on...
Terrific save. Terrific opportunity.
Not often you're all alone in front of the goaltender from this area of the ice. Great save.
Hey, Ray, what's going on down there?
Crosby's had an almost perfect night. Prominent since the puck has been dropped the very first time. Three goals in any night means you've had an almost perfect game.
Ray, he's certainly one of the three stars in my book. The draw, the tie-up, and his team prevails. The Penguins are moving the puck in their own end. Carried right through the middle of the neutral zone. A shot turned away.
The Hurricanes are hoping for running time here. Their goaltenders had such a bad night, they trail big.
Goalie to the bench, Ekstrom. Terrific pad save. And possession established on the pickup by Stepniak. And we get a penalty here. The referee strides over to hand it out. Pittsburgh's got a penalty up on the board. It's 2 minutes for elbowing.
No question, a penalty there, Doc. Anytime you see a player skating around with his elbow up, put him in a box.
Carolina's power play unit gets a rare 5-3. It's a special time for them to rocket home some goals.
2 minutes for elbowing.
Chip to Falk.
6 minutes, 36 seconds.
He retreats now, getting back to his own end. Falk's got it in the defensive zone, headed to center. Passing one off now to Skinner. Shoots one. Save. And here again is Ray.
Pittsburgh's game plan is obviously body first, puck second, and as a result, they've opened up all kinds of space in the offensive zone.
You're right, Ray. This is a physical game, especially played by the team that's up on the scoreboard. The Penguins with a face-off win. And that's a good job taking the pressure off. Out of his crease with a big goal stick. The puck stops right there. Now it's directed to Stempniak. And he is reefed.
He was looking to knock him into the third row.
Slid back across. Good shot, but a better save. Carolina's power play is over. Seems like a good thing they've had their problem. Broke it up well with the poke check. Pass cut. Pitching this one to Falk. Used the stick well, didn't he? That one by Fair. Wrister! The shot is off.
You know what, Doc? I can see why he missed the net. There was nothing there. He tried to be too fine. You know what, Doc? Instead of acting like this after the whistle, how about both teams play whistle to whistle like this?
Pittsburgh's increased their lead in this period by being on the body consistently, line to line to line, shift to shift to shift. They've not given the opponents any room to breathe.
The Penguins prevail again. The Hurricanes, in their own end, have control of the puck. Picks it up back there. Gains the zone.
to Haglund. Hammers one. Back and forth they go between the points. For the one-timer, off his helmet mask. A cover, and play is stopped.
Congratulations to our 50-50 grand prize winner.
If turkeys could fly, they'd be ringing his head right now. That one had to hurt. Hannafin's blocked so many pucks over the last couple of games, you would think he'd like to stick handle one of them once in a while.
The Penguins win that faceoff. Moving it to Rask. It's an onside play. That one is pointed to him. Snapped out of the air. And he'll hold on.
He's in great shape to make any kind of stop, but one like this is an easy one for him.
A little over 6 minutes to go. The Penguins very comfortable at 5-1. Pittsburgh's got a defensive zone win. Pass attempt to Sheary. On to Stempniak. Snapping a pass to Teravainen. Got it right back. The pass is off the mark. What a chance that would have been. The puck is thrown to McClement. Up the wing still with possession. That's a good solid hit. He'll feel that one. Outstanding offense met by solid goaltending. Pass cut. Trying to go to Stempniak. That one goes back in where a goaltender can make this play, not a defenseman or forward. And possession snapped up by McClement. Directing that one to Crosby. Gets in, looks over his options here. Turned a shot on net. The Hurricanes control the play through the neutral zone. So we're into the last minute. All is academic here. Taken over again. Looking to Crosby. Corralled it again. And it's a good pickup. Pitching it to McClement. Nicely into the zone. Passing one off now to Malkin. Now it's directed to Kunitz. Points it. Redirected. Stared him down and made the save.
Seems like he was in too tight on the goaltender.
And he'll cover.
Sometimes you got to be in good position just to make the stop, but you also got to be lucky. This puck changes direction and ends up hitting the goaltender more than he stops it.
Carolina's got a face-off win. Pitching this one to Skinner. Moving it to Lindholm. Enormous collision. Went to the backhand. The game is over. Pittsburgh's got another victory, and it was impressive.
Cruise control for the majority of this game, especially late.
So ends another game and another telecast. We hope you enjoyed this. Thanks for watching. For Eddie Olchek and Ray Ferraro, Mike Emmerich saying good night.